Welcome back. Today I am going to discuss about SCTP, Stream Control Transmission Protocol. It is another protocol used by transport layer. We have already discussed about UDP and TCP, the two protocols used in transport layer. Actually, SCTP is also a reliable protocol like TCP, but it is a message-oriented protocol. It combines the best features of both UDP and TCP. Actually, TCP is designed for internet application. The topics discussed are SCTP services and features, SCTP packet format. SCTP services, process to process communication. As far as transport layer is considered, the communication is process to process. Similar to TCP, SCTP also provides process to process communication. It uses all the well-known ports in TCP space. Also, it uses some other extra ports. Multiple streams. A connection in SCTP is known as association. Whereas in TCP, we term it as simply as a connection. And in the case of TCP, from a process to a receiving process, from a sending process to a receiving process, the streams go, the bytes go like a stream, or there is only a single stream. In the case of SCTP, there are many streams or multiple streams. The idea is, if one of the streams is blocked, then other streams can deliver data. Each stream can be used for a different type of traffic. For example, one stream can be used for regular traffic, whereas another one can be used for heavy traffic, etc. This figure shows the multiple stream concept very well. Here we have the sending process, and here is the receiving process. And from this single process, there are multiple streams to the single receiving process. Actually, in SCTP, the data unit is known as data chunks, whereas in TCP, it is bytes. So we term there as stream of bytes, whereas here it is stream of data chunks. That is, multiple streams are there for a single association. Multi-homing. This means a host can be connected to multiple IP addresses, or the sending and receiving host can define multiple IP addresses in each end for an association. When one path fails, we can use the other one. However, the sharing of load between these paths is not allowed in SCTP. Actually, it is very much useful while sending and receiving real-time payload, because internet actually uses real-time payloads. For example, internet telephony. This is explained in the figure. Here we have the client machine and the client process. Here the server process in the server machine, and here the client is connected to two IP addresses or two local networks with IP address IPv1 and IPv2, and the server is also connected to two different networks, local networks, with IP addresses IP3 and IP4. They are linked via internet. So the communication take place using these IP addresses. Actually, in the current implementations of SCTP, only one pair of IP address can be chosen for normal communication, and the other is used only when the main fails. Full duplex communication. Like TCP, SCTP also provides full duplex communication. That is, from the source to destination as well as in the reverse direction at the same time. Connection oriented service. In SCTP, the connection is termed as an association. So for a communication to take place, we need establishing a connection, that is establishing an association, data transfer and association termination. Reliable service. As it is a connection oriented service, SCTP provides a reliable service. For this, it uses the idea of acknowledgement. SCTP also implements error control, which is very much related with reliability. SCTP features. In SCTP, a unit of data is termed as a data chunk. There are many identification techniques used in SCTP, such as TSN, transmission sequence number, SI, stream identifier, SSN, stream sequence number, etc. So we can check one by one. First one, transmission sequence number. SCTP uses transmission sequence number or SSN to number the data chunks. We have actually data chunk to represent the data and control chunks for control information. The TSNs are given to data chunks only. We can compare this TSN to sequence number in TCP. These TSNs are 32 bit long and randomly initialized, and it lies in the range 0 to 2^32 - 1. So each data chunk is given a TSN, and while sending, this number, TSN number, will be there in its header, will be there in each of data chunks header. Stream identifier or SI. There are multiple streams in the case of SCTP. So whenever we want to send a data chunk through a stream, it must be identified. Suppose we have three streams, say stream 1, stream 2, stream 3. And if we are sending through stream 3, sending a data chunk through stream 3, it must be, that stream must be identified. So for that purpose, SCTP uses SI. Again, each data chunk must carry SI in its header. That is, each data chunk is having its TSN in the header. Also, it must have SI in the header. Here it is a 16-bit number starting from 0. Stream sequence number or SSN. When a data chunk arrives at the destination, it is to be delivered to the appropriate stream in proper order. As we have number of streams, it must be delivered properly. So, in addition to SI, SETP uses stream sequence number SSN. Actually, it is used to distinguish between different data chunks belonging to same stream. Different data chunks belonging to same stream and is very much useful to deliver data chunks in order. Packets. So we have data chunks to carry data, control chunks to carry control information. So data are carried as data chunks, or control information are carried as control chunks. So we can pack several data chunks and control chunks together, and this format is known as a packet. So actually a packet consists of several data chunks as well as control chunks. It is somewhat similar to segment in TCP. Acknowledgement number. In the case of TCP, the acknowledgement was byte oriented. Here in the case of SETP, as we are transferring chunks, so acknowledgement number is also chunk oriented. So they refer to TSN, that is transmission sequence number, which is the number of identification number for data chunk. Control chunks are also acknowledged, but they use a separate control chunk of appropriate type. For example, there is a control chunk init which is used in the establishment of an association, sent by the client side. When it is received at the receiver side, it must send the acknowledgement. So that acknowledgement is init ACK chunk. That is, separate chunks are therefore acknowledgement chunks are therefore control also control information. It must be noted that there is no need of TSN for control chunk. We use, or SETP use TSN only for data chunks. Flow control. It provides flow control, which is very useful in error control also. It is similar to that in TCP, but with some modifications. Error control, for the purpose of error control, it uses acknowledgements. Condition control. SETP implements condition control. Actually, SETP has slow start, that is exponential increase, if you represent it graphically. Slow start, congestion avoidance and congestion detection phases. Like TCP, SETP also uses fast transmission and fast recovery for congestion control purpose. So, to consolidate, in SETP, data chunk is numbered using TSN. To distinguish between different streams, SETP uses SI, stream identifier. To distinguish different data chunks belonging to same stream, SETP uses SSN, or stream sequence number. A SCTP packet format. The figure shows SCTP packet format. You can see a general header which is of 12 bytes and chunk 1, chunk 2 up to chunk n, they are of variable length. This is the actual packet format, which is very simple compared to that of TCP. Actually, we have both control chunks and data chunks, and in an SCTP packet, control chunks comes before data chunks. So we can discuss on the various fields in the general header and as well as general header. So here we have source port address and here it is the destination port address. As I told you earlier, it is a transport layer protocol and it is a process to process communication, so we need port numbers similar to that in TCP. So we have source port address and destination port address, both are of 16 bits. Next comes verification tag of 32 bits and checksum of 32 bits. So the general header defines the endpoints. Source port address 16 bit and destination port address 16 bit. Now verification tag. It is 32 bit field. This is a number that matches a packet to an association. Packet is the data unit and a unit containing data chunks and control chunks. And this is to be delivered through an association, over an association. So actually this verification tag is a number that matches a packet to an association. Actually it serves as an identifier for the association. It is repeated in every packet during the association, this verification tag. For each and every packet, this verification tag is to be mentioned. One more thing is, we have client to server as well as server to client communication. And separate verification tags are to be used for each direction. Checksum, it is again a 32 bit field. As you know, it is for error detection correction mechanism. Actually, SCTP contains CRC is 32 bit, that is CRC 32 checksum. This table shows some of the chunks used by SCTP. Already I have told you about init and init ACK. Both are used in the case of connection establishment or association establishment. Here also we have cookie echo and cookie ACK, that is also used in connection with association establishment. So you can go through this, explanations are given. Shutdown is actually for termination of association, and so these are the type, and these are the name of the chunk, and this is the corresponding description. You can take a reference. Now I have told you about TSN, transmission sequence number, to number the data chunk, SI to number the stream, to identify the stream, SSN that is stream sequence number, to distinguish different data chunks belonging to the same stream. So this relationship we can make it little more clear with the help of this example. So here is the first packet, second packet, third packet and fourth packet, that is for this connection communication, or actually there are four packets. just assume like that. So we have the header. Header is for each and every packet must contain this header, that is general header. General header includes, as already told, source port address, destination port address, verification tag, CRC, etc. This header, it must be there in each and every packet. Now coming to the data chunks, control chunks and all. And already I told you that within a packet the control chunks comes before the data chunk. So here every packet you can see the first the control chunk appears. So next comes the data chunks. You can see TSN is 101. TSN means transmission sequence number. It is the number of the data chunk. So this is a number. SI means stream identification, and you can see here is SI is 0, here SI is 1, and here SI is 2. Yes, we have 3 streams, SI 1, SI 0, stream 0, stream 1 and stream 2. So we are numbering it as SI 0, SI 1 and SI as 2, 3 streams are there. So this means TSN is 101 means it is the number of the transmission sequence number of the data chunk on the stream 0, and the sequence number, stream sequence number is 0, that is within this stream this data chunk is at the position 0. So coming to second one, here the number of data chunk, transmission sequence number is 102 on the same stream, and on that stream it is the its number is SSN is 1. So for the first data chunk SSN is 0, second data chunk SSN is 1, third SSN is 3, and fourth SSN is third SSN is 2, and fourth SSN is 3. I think it's clear now. That is transmission sequence number, that is the data chunk number is 101, 102, 103, 104, and these data chunks 101 to 104 belongs to the same stream, that is stream 0, and within the stream they are having SSN, stream sequence number, as 0123. Just for understanding, color difference is there. So coming to this portion, so this is the first packet. This first packet can contain only 3 data chunks. So the next data chunk in the same communication is packed in the second packet, and here the continuation, that is here the transmission sequence number is 105, that is continuation is given, transmission sequence number after 104 for that association, for that message passing. Next data chunk number is 105, but we have to notice that stream sequence number is stream identifier is 1, that is it is the second stream, and within that stream this data chunk with the number TSN 105, the SSN is 0, or you can say it is a 0th position, we can think like that. And next data chunk is 106, TSN is 106 of the same stream, but its SSN is 1. For the next data chunk, SSN is 2, TSN 107 for the same stream, that is for the second stream, that is SI1, we have 3 data chunks with the TSNs 105, 106, 107, and their position or their identification within the stream is 012. Similarly, here comes next data chunk 108, 109, 110 and 111 are the TSNs, and here is the next stream represented in a different color. So stream SI is 2, so SI 0 is over here, SI 1 is over here, and SI is 2 is over here. Within that stream This data chunk is having the SSN 0, 109 data chunk 109 is having the SSN 1, and 110 is having SSN 2, 111 is having SSN 3. So this is actually the relationship or how we can represent the data chunks in streams and packets. So with that, I am winding up this session. Thank you.